The dangers of prescription drugs are mostly well known, but most people believe that their over-the-counter medications are safe to take. That's normally the case, but the most popular drug in America, acetaminophen, has been linked to a host of problems, and the FDA has been waiting 40 years to issue warnings about the drug. For more on this, let's go to attorney Will Atkinson. Will, I think a lot of people are generally under the assumption that over-the-counter drugs are a heck of a lot safer than prescription drugs, and for the most case, they really are. I mean, you take a drug like acetaminophen, which is Tylenol, that's been on the market for decades and decades and decades. But we know now, and we knew as early as about 40 or 50 years ago, that Tylenol is not nearly as safe as the makers of the drug want us to believe. Walk us through a little bit with the reality of acetaminophen.
That's right. Acetaminophen is the active ingredient in Tylenol. Everybody's probably taken this drug at one time in their life. Actually, one in six Americans takes it every week. So it's extremely popular. And it's been around, it was first discovered, I think, in the 19th century. Tylenol was introduced to the market in the 1950s. So it's a very familiar drug. And if you raise any safety concerns about it, you know, people's first reaction is going to be to think that you're nuts. Everybody takes Tylenol and there's no problem. But the risks with acetaminophen, which as I said was the active ingredient in Tylenol, is that it has a narrow therapeutic range. And what that means is it's easy to overdose. And a lot of Americans do. Every year, 150 Americans die from accidentally overdosing on acetaminophen. Which makes it the number one killer among over-the-counter pain relievers. So it's a drug that is deceptively dangerous as compared to ibuprofen and aspirin. With those drugs, you need to take six times the recommended daily dose to get into the danger zone. But with acetaminophen, you only need to take twice introduce serious risks to your health.
I was going to say, even with some people, we've seen them with the recommended dose, they still get some of the symptoms of overdose there too.
That's right. It's also the number one cause of acute liver damage in the United States. And even with the recommended daily dose, especially with these Tylenol extra strength pills, you can have serious health problems.
Well, you know, one of the things with Tylenol, one of the reasons why this story is not necessarily as popular as, say, problems with Vioxx or other big pills that have resulted in massive lawsuits, is that litigation against Tylenol or acetaminophen manufacturers is very difficult. When you're talking about a drug that is so incredibly common, it's very difficult to prove causality in a lawsuit setting. Now, we've seen it being proved time and time again in a laboratory setting, but, you know, skilled defense attorneys are able to spin it and say, well, this person has liver damage, but they took Tylenol, they took this pill, they drank occasionally. So it's very difficult, and that's why I think the public is less aware of the dangers of Tylenol as opposed to, say, these big-ticket pharmaceuticals that result in massive litigation. But as I just mentioned, you know, this has been proven in a lab setting. We know that Tylenol causes liver damage. Acetaminophen causes liver damage. So we have this knowledge. We know that it's killing at least 150 people a year, sending thousands of more to the emergency room. What's the FDA doing about any of this?
That's a good question. Critics have said the FDA is not doing enough. They're really they're inert. In the 1970s. It was known that there were serious risks with acetaminophen, but since it's an over-the-counter drug, for the most part, there are prescription drugs that use acetaminophen, but for the most part, it's an over-the-counter drug. That's what Tylenol is. And at the FDA, over-the-counter drugs are subject to a process known as a monograph system. And It's interesting that this is for over-the-counter drugs. It requires an extremely lengthy period of public debate, economic analysis, legal review, and on and on and on, and mountains of paperwork and legal filings to make even the smallest changes to an over-the-counter drug. If it was a prescription drug, The FDA can make regulatory rulings and change the labeling quickly. But with this monograph system, which is what acetaminophen is primarily subject to, it just takes forever to make any changes, and that's what's been happening. In 2009, the FDA convened a panel of researchers, scientists, and experts who recommended that extra-strength Tylenol should be a prescription drug. And McNeil Consumer Healthcare, which is Johnson & Johnson's subsidiary that makes and markets Tylenol, of course, unleashed the hounds, so to speak, of lobbyists and their minions, their lawyers, who started lobbying the FDA, the White House, Congress, to prevent this from occurring, which is what's happened. In 2009, this FDA panel recommended that extra-strength Tylenol should be a prescription drug, and nothing's happened since then.
And that's a great point to point out there, is the fact that these companies have armies of lobbyists. They have millions upon millions of dollars to spend on campaign donations, buying politicians here and there. And so that's one of the main reasons here. Plus, we also have to consider the fact that acetaminophen is marketed by many, many, many different companies. So you're not talking about, again, with the Vioxx issue, which was a Merck drug, I believe. And so that's one company trying to fight for one pill. Now, the case of Tylenol, or acetaminophen, I should say, is you have strings of companies all with an interest in this because they all market their own brand of acetaminophen. And another reason that is why it's so difficult for litigation, because you don't know which one the person took. It's hard to hold anybody accountable. So we have about a minute left here. FDA has known about this for 40 years. 40 years we've known about the dangers. Is there any movement on the horizon to possibly make this safer and to get this word out to consumers?
Well, regulators haven't shown any appetite to properly control this drug that in the interest of public safety. So what's happening is this debate is taking place in the courts, in the civil litigation system. There are over 200 federal and state lawsuits pending against the maker of Tylenol, the McNeil Consumer Healthcare, the subsidiary of Johnson & Johnson. So we're going to see how those shake out. They look pretty favorable for the plaintiffs, who many of them suffered tragic injuries. Some died after taking amounts of Tylenol that you wouldn't think would be dangerous. And that's really the risk here.
Will Atkinson, thank you very much for telling us this story today. Stay on top of this issue. We appreciate everything that you do, and thanks for being with us today.